Big up to all Aromatic Realistic TV viewers and subscribers.
Reality check, man, from your device, you know it's a unique one, Aromatic Realistic TV. And today my topic of discussion is, why is it the pastors in Jamaica is so quiet? Why is it the pastors in Jamaica, who's supposed to lead from the front and set example for the rest of the country, is so quiet? Anyway, before I go any further, blessed Sunday to all of you who are Sunday worshipers. And for the Sabbath, blessed afternoon. And today, I really want to talk about the pastors and the lack of a representation that the people of Jamaica is getting from their spiritual leader. And today, I'm being specific. I'm talking about the pastors. And why are they so contented knowing and seeing the situation that the Jamaican people are going through? You know, the dictatorship style from the Andrew Holness-led administration, the oppression, you know, the victimization, the poverty, the hunger, the suffering. But yet still, they are contented. So it is telling me they are satisfied with their life. They are satisfied with their life of living when their sheep are suffering. The pastors who are in high places are being satisfied with their life while the flock that they lead, the sheep, is suffering. And it draw me to this conclusion. It says, Mark Stewart and Peter Chambers is the only two outstanding pastors in Jamaica that is looking over their sheep. And I say that without no apology. Mark Stewart, Peter Chambers, is the only two outstanding pastors in Jamaica that is looking over their sheep. And one would say, Aromatic, why are you drawing that broad conclusion? Or why you, how you get to this conclusion? What do you mean when you say Mark Stewart and Peter Chambers is the only two outstanding pastors is looking out after their flock in Jamaica? But if you just quietly listen as I make my presentation, then I hope you will understand where I'm coming from and where I'm going. Remember, the pastors is the shepherds, and their members would be the sheep. The pastors would be the shepherds, and the members of that congregation, of that church, would be. So, if you see where your sheep is going to bandage, or under suffering, or being targeted, being victimized, being oppressed, 2 millions of them cannot afford a nutrition meal on a daily basis, and you are content with that, something is wrong. So Let us take a look at the states of emergency that the Prime Minister of Jamaica have and the youth them in Jamaica. So let us take a look at the states of emergency. The states of emergency that the Prime Minister have going on for years now against the youths of Jamaica. Where the Prime Minister just creep up the youth them, carry them, go jail them, 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, up to a year, and the youth them are not charged. That is against their constitution, right? So, listen what the constitution says. A situation of national danger or disaster in which the government suspended normal constitution procedure in order to regain control. A situation of national danger or disaster in which the government suspended normal constitution procedure in order to regain control. Now, the thing here, I want you to look at these two words, danger and disaster. We don't have a war. Jamaica is not under siege. So therefore, we don't need to call a state of emergency. Disaster. We don't have flood. We don't have storm. We don't have hurricane. We just get a earthquake the other day, and they did not call a state of emergency. Now, these are one of the things that the people of Jamaica is going through. Knowing that the youth them may be not that intellect to understand and know the constitution, but the pastors are educated. Some of them are well qualified, so they would know the rules and the laws of the constitution. So therefore, they should know that the Prime Minister of Jamaica, Andrew Holness, is breaching the Constitution. He's breaking the law where the Constitution regard. It says, the Constitution say, in danger are states of emergency. Jamaica is not going through a state of emergency right now. Jamaica is not under no danger. And the Constitution is not working. So why are they still having this state of emergency, incarcerating the youth them without any charge, 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, over a year? And our leaders, who are the pastors, who are in high authority, they understand to see that their sheep gone astray and they are not voicing their opinion on behalf of those people. It is wrong, wrong, wrong. So one would have to ask, why is it they are so quiet? These are people who is competent. Some of these people are highly educated, intellect, so they know the rules of the constitution. And they know that the rule of the constitution being broken by Andrew Holness. So why are they not speaking up against it and say that they are man of God and man of integrity, man of honesty, man of decency? Why are they not speaking up? Why are they not speaking up? So your sheep is in poverty because you pastors are the shepherds of Jamaica. And the people of Jamaica now is going through a rough time under this Andrew Holness-led administration, where poverty is on the rise, starvation, hunger is on the rise, corruption in his administration, where they're just robbing taxpayers right, left, and center. They just bend us over as taxpayers and rape us dry. rape us dry right in front of our eyes. Victimization. That's what the Jamaican people is undergoing. Dictatorship under this Andrew Holness administration, because whatever he said, it must not be questioned. Whatever Andrew Holness said, it must be law. Dare you to question this man. So if your sheep is being oppressed by this dictatorship leader, then why are you still so silent? If your sheep is going through drought where the grass is drying up and there is nothing for them to eat, there is no rain, so the water source is getting scarce. They've been abused and victimized by law enforcement. And you, as the shepherd, is still being silent. And the saying says, silent means consent. Silence means consent. If you are not against the oppression, the poverty, the starvation, the hunger, the corruption, you are for it. So your sheep is being oppressed. Your sheep is being oppressed. And you are still being silent. Your sheep is being oppressed. I'm talking to pastors of Jamaica, you know, them me a chat to. Your sheep is being oppressed. And you are still being silent. In spite of the dictatorship, in spite of the state of emergency, in spite of the police beating, in spite of losing their goods and their food in the market, in spite of taking away their raft and cut them up at White River, in spite of go by Clifton and lick down them house, in spite of going to the House of Parliament and give yourself a 300% raise, and so you are not giving the police a raise, you're not giving the teacher a raise, you're not giving the immigration officer a raise, you're not giving the fireman a raise, you're not giving any low rank public servant a raise. Right? And you are okay. You are content with that. But the same people who has been oppressed by this dictator, Andrew Holness and his administration, the same people who can hardly make ends meet, where you see now where they apply new bus fare raises on them, they could hardly scrape by before, and you apply another level of pressure on them. We don't hear you, pastor, come out and speak up on behalf of these people. But this is what puzzles me, and this is one of the reasons why I have to do this content. At the same time, the same people who has been oppressed, some of them can't find it hard for them to make ends meet. You're still looking for those people on a Saturday morning, on a Sunday morning, or on a Sunday afternoon, or on a Saturday afternoon, on a Wednesday night, for them to bring you your tithes and your offering. The same people who has been oppressed, who has been victimized, the same people who hardly can make ends meet, you're still looking for them to bring you your fat tide on your offering. But yet still, you are so silent. You are so silent to speak up on their behalf outside of your four corners. of that temple. But I want you pastors to remember, as I bring you back down memory lane, just a few years ago, just a few years ago, in the pandemic, when the Prime Minister of Jamaica closed the doors of all the churches and tell you guys to stay home, and when he do give you access, it was like 4 or 5 or 6. A lot of us lost loved ones, and what, 20, 30 people allowed. I just want to remember that in the heights of the pandemic, when your Prime Minister Andrew Holness closed all the doors of the churches and telling us if he stay on the yard, and when he do open and give you a little leeway, in regular church, it was like 6 or 7. But I also can recall where the Prime Minister of Jamaica grant a permit for a secular concert in Negril called Dream Weekend. In case you did not hear, let me repeat it again so you can understand. I can recall the Prime Minister of Jamaica, Andrew Holness, grant a permit for a secular concert in Negril called Dream Weekend that hosts thousands of people. That hosts thousands of people, Dream Weekend. You give the church access, 6 or 7 or 8 can congregate on a Sunday or on a Wednesday night service. But outside of that, you granted a permit for a secular concert, Dream Weekend in Negril, for thousands of people. For thousands of people. So what that is telling me, that this man have no respect and no regard for even the churches. This man, Andrew Holness, have no respect or no regards for even the churches. So my question to you, pastors, then why are you still so silent? He gave the church the access to accommodate 6 or 7 or 8 for Sunday worship, for Wednesday night prayer meeting. But on the other hand, he granted a permit for a secular concert in Negril called Dream Weekend for thousands of people. In case you guys don't know, let me remind you what take place. So my question to you pastors is, if this man have no respect and no regard for the churches, then why are you pastors are so silent? And this is the reason why I draw my own conclusion and says Mark Stewart and Peter Chambers, without no apology to no guy, is the only two outstanding pastors in Jamaica that is looking over their sheep? Why is the pastors of Jamaica is so contented? My question to my fellow man and woman, the citizen of Jamaica, at home and in the diaspora abroad, why is the pastor so contented? You are satisfied with your life. You pastors are satisfied with the life that you are living when your sheep is being suffering. So it is telling me that your interest is not for your sheep. Your interest is for your tithes and your offerings. Why do you draw that conclusion, Aromatic? If one of your sheep from your flock, or a goat or a cow, name it, disappear, that shepherd would rather to stay up right throughout the night and look for that missing herd rather than go to bed and sleep and don't know what is taking place out there in the wild with his herd that is missing. So if your sheep in Jamaica is being oppressed under poverty, corruption, victimization, dictatorship, and you are silent, and you are silent, what that is telling me, you are not for the people's interest. You don't have the people's wills. You don't have the people at heart. You care about what the people can bring to that institution, and what they bring to that institution is their fat tithe and their fat offering. Why are you so contented? Why? That's the question, Jamaica. We need to ask these pastors, why are they so contented? Why are they so satisfied with their life of living when their sheep is being suffering? Ask them these questions, Jamaica. Ask them these questions. Remember, Jamaica, a pastor is a shepherd, and the member of his congregation is his sheep. So it is the responsibility of the shepherd to guide over his sheep. It is the responsibility of the shepherd to know every step and every track that his sheep are going through. It is the responsibility of the shepherd to make sure that the sheep have fresh grass to eat. It is the responsibility of the shepherd to make sure that the sheep have fresh water to drink. So why is the shepherd is so silent? And it come back again. When I say silent, mean consent. And if you are not against, you are for it. If you are not against, you are for it. Why is the pastors are so silent? Jamaica, this is the question that we need to ask. Why is our pastors being so silent? Let us look back on the states of emergency. And the Prime Minister of Jamaica, Andrew Holness, is now using the states of emergency like a crime fighting solution. when it is not working? Because states of emergency now is around for a long time. But when you look at the rate or crime is climbing, it is telling you, you don't even need rocket scientists to figure that out, that it is not working. It is not working. So we go and we look up the definition of the state of emergency. And what it is saying, a situation of national danger. It must be a situation of national danger or disaster. If Jamaica they go a war, or somebody want to try to attack we, or something, or hurricane, flood, fire, earthquake, that's the time you call for a state of emergency, to a disaster in which the government suspended normal constitution procedure in order to regain control. So if we don't have danger, and if we don't have any disaster, it is against your constitution right to be held in states of emergency lockup for 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, 9 months, and 10 months. And that is the reason why Isaac Buchanan and his client are winning a lot of those cases against the government of Jamaica, because it's against the people's constitution right. And if the pastors cannot speak up on something like this, and as I said before, a lot of these pastors are well competent, they are educated, intellect, some of them are scholars, so what that is telling me, that they would know the constitution, rules and laws. So my question is, if the government of Jamaica is breaking the rules and laws of the constitution, you want to tell me that not even that the pastors of Jamaica can speak against? You understand what I'm saying? It's telling you that something is wrong, right? And let I just bring back their attention to the pandemic. And when the prime minister of Jamaica tell all the churches in Jamaica to close their doors and turn on them yard. Close on the door and turn on the yard. And when he do give them the access to go back and gather, to keep them prayer meeting and their praise and worship on Sunday and their Sunday service, he gave them 7, 8, or 9 for the churches, you know. The churches that they all run to shed them crocodile tears. You understand, for people reach out and say, yes, oh, our pastor, our prime minister, this and that and church. You're tricking the people. You're tricking the people. They don't care about the church. Because if you care about the church, you would not give the church the permission only to allow 7, 8, or 9 people. But at the same time, you granted a permit for a secular concert in Negril called Dream Weekend for thousands of people. So this man have no regard or no care for the churches. And if that be the case, then one would have to ask, then why is the pastors so silent? Why are they so silent? Why are they so compromised? Why are they so compromised? Why are they so satisfied? Why are they so satisfied? And this is the reason why Aromatic draw his own conclusion and says Mark Stewart and Peter Chambers is the only two outstanding pastor in Jamaica who is looking over their sheep. And all the other pastors, they are like wolf in sheep clothing. They're like wolf in sheep clothing. Why their voice can't be heard? Your sheep is going through drought. No grass, no water. But you stand by and see your sheep is being perished. Poverty, corruption, victimization, dictatorship, starvation, brutalization. And you are okay. You're satisfied with your life when your sheep are all suffering. The question, Jamaica, that we need to ask them, why are you guys so contented? Why are you guys so contented? We've been oppressed under poverty. We've been enslaved, victimized. But you're still looking forward for your fat tithe and your fat offering. I know this is not going to go down well with some of you guys, because you don't believe in God as only believe in a someone pastor. I said you don't believe in God as only believe in a pastor. But I want to tell someone this. You know why God give you no wisdom, knowledge, and understanding? And you know why he gives someone the dominion to write the Bible? So you can read along and understand. So I don't need a pastor to tell me, if I go down there and thief, it's something wrong. I don't need a pastor to tell me, if you go there and you cheat by your wife, fornication. And I don't need a pastor to tell me that. I don't need a pastor to tell me that if I go over there and gossip behind my brother and my sister back, it is wrong. I don't need a pastor to tell me that, because common sense and wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, that's what he gave to me. So my spiritual journey is all about to still communicate with my day-to-day living and the experience that I gather today. I should use that experience to keep me along my journey and stay connected on my spiritual journey. I'm begging you, please. Not begging you, but I'm just telling you. My platform is not for stupid people. I don't have time to waste on people who is unrepairable. So therefore, you don't have to come on my platform. Just scroll along. Just scroll along, man. Don't come over here. You understand what I'm saying? Because we don't deal with losers over here. And if you are dunce, if you are so dunce in a way, be unrepairable, I really don't have time to waste. I will repeat. As I said, if you are dunce in a way where you are so dunce, where you are behind repairable, aromatic, no, I have no time to waste on you. So please, just scroll along when you see my content. You understand what I'm saying? Anyway, my people, remember to stay tuned to Aromatic Realistic TV. We tell them so to like and share, follow us over YouTube, touch the notification, and make sure you like and share, because when you do so, it get to go into the YouTube algorithm, because the people who we want to get the message is the grassroots. We are not shooting for the scholars, the intellect, the brain box, you understand, of Jamaica. We are trying to reach the inner city, the urban and rural Jamaica. The youth, them who the system give up on. The message is really for them. So by you liking and sharing, it will go into the YouTube algorithm and it will circulate all over the globe. So do that for Aromatic Realistic TV. I continue to tell you that no man is an island and no man stand alone. Love your brother and your sisters. Show them respect, man. Because if you are looking respect from me, then why you can't have a little courtesy within yourself to show someone else that respect? A little respect goes a far way. You understand what I'm saying? The struggle is real. But how much realer can the struggle get? If you continue to sit around and pity in yourself, and what's going to happen? You're going to remain in that same situation until you decide to pull yourself out of that situation. Use up the wisdom and the knowledge. Use up a little common sense. That's what Almighty God give to you, brother. So use whatever he give to you as your advantage and stop complaining. You understand what I'm saying? Tell them, say, life over death. The more them a fight you, you kill them with love. Love them from a distance. Love them from a distance. You tell them, say, God and good rule. Be well. Be well. Until then, out of love. Out of love. Out of love. Out. Bless.